Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining me. I'm Cheryl and this is Your Journey Yoga. And today we're going to do a dynamic warm up for whatever activity you have in store. Working from head to toe, it's going to be a constant movement. So dynamic meaning we're not going to be staying still in a static pose to stretch. We will be moving in a dynamic way. So give yourself plenty of space. You can have a mat. You don't have to have a mat. You can do this actually outside if you're going for a run, if you're about to play tennis, golf, whatever the activity may be. You don't necessarily have to be on your mat, and you absolutely don't have to be barefoot. Yes, just doing it here on my mat and barefoot. So we're going to take a few moments to get the body ready for whatever activity you have in store. We're going to open up our feet just a little bit wider, and we're just going to sway side to side. So as we swing those arms, we're going to allow the feet to move. If you're barefoot, yeah, you might feel a little stretch in the toes. You might even if you have shoes on. So depending upon what kind of shoes you have on, we're going to come back to center and we're going to bring those feet back together and extend those arms, reach it up. And as you exhale, pull those elbows back and down, open your chest, reach it up. And as you exhale, pull those elbows back and down, open your chest and we reach and pull. We're going to add some movement with those arms. Reach it up, step it wide, and exhale. Toes are turned out, bend the knees. Step it back in. Feet are going to stay wide. Step it out, other side. Pull and reach and pull and reach one more. Pull and reach. Pull the hands to heart center, heel toe those feet back in, and we're going to lateral lunge it to the left. We're going to do a knee lift, little balance, lateral lunge. Knee lift, whatever direction your knee is pointing, that's the direction your toes are pointing. And lift. It's a fairly good size motion. You can tailor it to you. One more. Keeping that core strong. Hold your balance. And we're going to flex the foot. And we're going to open and close the leg. Working the hips. We're going to be strengthening the hips as well as working that range of motion. One more time. Hold it open. And we're going to press the heel down and lift it. Press it down and lift it. Warming up the quads, warming up the hip flexors, getting into that glute med. One more time, lift it, pull it back to center, and release. We take it to the right. Lateral lunge to a knee lift. First one might be a little rough on the balance. And lift. And lateral lunge. And lift. Beautiful. Finding that balance, feeling that connection of the full sole of the foot to the ground. One more. And we're going to hold it up. Find your balance. And we're going to open and close. Open. You can have your arms out to a T. You can hold on to something if you need to. Open and close. Open and close. One more time. We open and we hold it open. We press that heel down and lift it. Press it down and lift it strong through that supporting leg. One more time. Press it down and lift it and back to center and step. I'm going to turn to the side. You don't have to. Just room for that backstepping lunge. We're going to sweep those arms back to a backstepping lunge. We're going to do a big circle in our arms. Backstepping lunge. Big circle with the arms and through the hip. Backstepping lunge. Big circle with those arms and back to a lunge. So we're just crossing the arms in front. A hip roll. Little brain game. Breathe. Last one and step it down. Other side. We cross. We open and into out hip roll. We cross. We open into out hip roll. Little brain game. Firing up that brain. New nerve pathways. Challenging our balance. You might feel more coordinated on one side than the other. It's fine. Breathe. Into out hip roll and step it down. Let's heel toe those feet open. Heel toe. We're going to take it out. We're going to take it in. If you need to work with those hands, do. Bring it back in. Again, take it out. Warming up the ankles, hips. You can go as wide as you want to, and then bring it back in. This time we're going to take it wide. We're going to hold it wide. Take it a little bit wider than you would normally. Toes are turned out, hands to heart center. We lateral lunge side to side. As we come into that deeper stance, that wider stance, we're going to feel a nice long stretch through the inner thigh. We're firing up the legs. And breathe. Add the arms, reach it up and pull it down. Reach it up and pull it down. Reach and pull. Reach one more time each side. Come back up and sunflowers, grand plié. If you need to bring those feet in a little bit, yes, you can. You don't need to. Make it big, make it beautiful. Two more. Reach it up. And last one. Pull the hands to heart center mindfully. Heel toe those feet in. Make it big. Feel that good stretch in the outer ankle. Feel that rotation of the head of the femur in your hip joint. Reach it up. As you exhale, right hand down, left arm high, lean in and reach. Both arms come up. And exhale, lean in and reach. We're going to do that two more times each side. Reach it up. And exhale. Reach it up. And exhale. Reach it up. One more time. Exhale. Reach it up. Pull the hands to heart center. Shift your weight to your right foot, left knee, out to in, out to in. Just working those hip rolls again, out to in, out to in. One more time. We're going to keep that knee in front, turning sideways again, and we're going to kick it back and forward so that leg goes long, kicking back and front. You can make this as big as you want. You can have those arms out to a T. If having the hands at heart center is not quite enough of that balance that we need, one more. Knee comes in. We bring the hands to the shins. Now just a little static hold. Stretching hip flexors, rolling the ankles. Both directions. And go ahead and release that. And arms come out to a T if you like, or hands to heart center. We shift our weight to our left foot. Out to in. Out to in. Out to in. Good. Those hip rolls. What do you notice? It's a little more challenging on one side to hold your balance. It's challenging to hold your balance as you add movement. One more. We bring it to center. Arms are out to a T. We extend that left leg and we sweep it back and front. Adding a little flex of your foot. And again, you can make this as big of a motion as feels right to you. Warming up those glutes and hamstrings. Firing up those core muscles. Last one. Pull it in. Hold it in. Bring your hands to your shin. Pull that knee up. And just point and flex your foot. Roll your ankle. Breathe. So hopefully you've noticed body's gotten a little warmer. Heart rate's gone up just a little bit with some of these things. And gently release. We roll those shoulders up and back. Again, roll those shoulders up and back. Bring the hands behind your head, interlace your fingers. As you exhale, hinge it forward halfway. And rise. Again, halfway down. And rise. One more time, take it halfway down. And rise. As you exhale, turn to the right. Keep your pelvis facing front. And inhale it back to center. Exhale, turn to the left. Keep your pelvis facing front and come back to center. That feels really good. And rotate it and come back to center. It's just interesting to me. Some days, some things feel so much better than other days. One more time. Take it to the right and back to center and take it to the left and back to center and release those arms. Down by your sides. I hope you feel warm. I hope you feel ready for whatever activity it is you're about to start. I hope it's successful and you have a blast. Take care of yourself. Thanks for being here. And I always look forward to the next time. Until then, light, love, and namaste.